So I play the character of Frederica, and she's a very quiet, sweet, introverted girl who is thrown into situations that she's not ready for. So she's 16 years old and she's at a horrible boarding school and knows she's going to be married to this man that she doesn't love, and she runs away to try and make it better, but in the end ends up being in the same house as this man she's meant to be married to. It's a story about a mother and a daughter, really, though, who have no control over their lives. They have no money, and the only way that they can get it is by getting married to someone. And Lady Susan isn't necessarily the kindest character and doesn't necessarily do it in the best way, but ultimately she doesn't want her daughter to be impoverished. So, yeah, I think that's the gist.
Lady Susan's not the kindest character, particularly to yours, but what was Kate like? Was she nicer on set, we hope?
Yes, Kate was absolutely lovely on set. And just the whole gang, like, all together, everyone was just so clever, so funny, so witty, and just so up for enjoying themselves. So, for me, like, being around all these actors I'd admired for years and just, like, listening to them chat was just wonderful.
Obviously, Austen's iconic, but what do you think sets this story perhaps apart from what we already know and love of her work?
Of Kate or Austen?
Oh, no, sorry, of Austen.
Of Austen's. What I really love about Love and Friendship is that we have a woman who doesn't behave particularly well, and she doesn't get punished for it, because I think we're so used to watching films where if a woman just deviates slightly from being super virtuous, she, like, goes up in flames. And I think that's what's really interesting about it. You know, she doesn't get her comeuppance. She succeeds. She does it. So that's what's different, I think. I don't know if I should say this, but I remember once where I'd kind of overindulged when I was like 15 and was very unwell the next day, and we just watched all of Underworld, and I just fell in love with her. I was like, this is the coolest woman ever. Like, and then I thought she was like, that she was British as well, because I'd never seen a British superhero, and I was like, oh my gosh, she's awesome. And yeah, she's just so clever. Like, I think it was just watching the way that she used the words, and also just how effortlessly she did it, was really inspiring to watch. And yeah, it was great. All the scenes were so easy with her, because she's just wonderful. Being on a screen with Tom Bennett is almost impossible to keep a straight face. Like, there was one particular one where I'm just coming out. It's at the beginning of the film when we're just coming out of a big house going down the stairs, and his funny run coming out, but I was going first, so I'd get into the trailer and be like, oh my gosh, I can laugh at his funny run, because yeah, he's a comic genius. I'm so glad that everyone's seeing it, because he is just a gem. Wait, it was very just open for us to try lots of things. Like, he wasn't at all rigid about the script, which was really lovely. And so I think every character made the script slightly their own, but like with Wit's guidance. Yeah, Lady Susan probably had a harder start in life than Frederica. Like, she's obviously had to be manipulative to survive, and I don't know if Frederica would eventually develop that, or she's just not made. I don't think Frederica's a particular survivor, whereas Lady Susan, you know, in an apocalypse, she'd be there at the end, you know, if the zombies came in, she'd survive. But Frederica, I think, would die pretty soon. She's kind, which I think is a thing that's constantly undervalued. Like, she sees the good in everyone, and she's lovely to everyone. And even when she's suffering and having everyone be horrible around her, she doesn't succumb to that. So I think that strength of character is really wonderful, and it was great to play someone like that.